Hello, party people. We've got the Yamaha R1 2008, and it has the engine 5VY, same engine like on 2005 onwards bikes. And we've got today to change the stator, which is the most common problem on these bikes. So if you haven't done it yet, just change it, because it will go bang soon. So in order for you to change it, you're gonna need RMstator. You're gonna need a flywheel. This is the flywheel with the improved sleeve on it. You can see it on the older model. You have those magnet strips here which collapse and grinds the stator. So we've got this new one, improved, the flywheel, and we've got the stator here. The coil. And you're gonna need also the gasket for it, which goes kind of like that. Right. So this being said, and you're gonna need to flush the old oil and change the oil filter as well. Sometimes what happens, new oil filter, and the guy said the washer from the drainage plug of the oil sump in there. Right. Well, you need to change the oil because sometimes pieces of this ends up in the engine if you're not lucky enough, or if you still ride it after you hear noises inside. So you need to flush the oil, drain the oil. Right. So in order for you to change the RMstator, you need this cover off. You need some Allen keys, 6mm for this three and 5mm for this. That's easy enough, but you've got the wires that goes all the way in the frame and goes in the air box for the regulator. So you need to disconnect that. This is the plug here. You need to disconnect the regulator. Right, so we're gonna start by removing this fairing and this panel here, that panel on that other side, and then loosen all this, that bolt there, and there's some bolts here on each side, and just lift the tank and expose the airbox thing and just disconnect the regulator. Right, so crack on. You need to remove the lower fairing, which has one bolt here, one there, one here, and one here. But you need to remove this lower fairing first. expose this bit. Now we need to remove this panel. This bolt here from the bracket, tank bracket. I need to take it off completely. One here. And another one of these on that other side, the pair of them. Just need to lift it, and that's your air filter thing. And just you need a Phillips. We've got the air box exposed. And now we've got nine screws to remove. So we can take the air filter off and expose the regulator. Air box covered off, nice and clean. And we've got there the air filter, KN filter. Take this off, and you can see there is the. Don't have a torch, and I light the torch. And that's your regulator there. And you just need to unplug this one here. The wire that goes all the way, that's the wire of the stator. Disconnect those clips and then just follow it. Is this one here? As usual, my phone doesn't zoom, doesn't focus. That's your wire that goes there. So now you've got that thing off. Can remove these bolts. So I've removed the regulator, which that's the position there. I've plugged it. You can see these two bolts holding this down, and I need you for me in order to take this plug out. I need to remove this panel. You can't remove this panel unless you take the whole throttle body out. So you can see there's one bolt there holding it down. There's two there, one there, one there, one in there, one in there, and as well there's that hose, vacuum hose on this side and on that side. On this side should be another one. This one here. So take those hoses off, unscrew those, and this whole thing can come out. And then that panel, this panel here. Again, my phone won't focus. That panel can be removed, so we can take the plug, the wire all the way out. This is the throttle body removed, so you need to make sure you release these bolts. There's one in there, one, two, three, four on this side, and then there's one all the way down there, one there, and one there. Six of them. And then you've got this vacuum hose here, another vacuum hose on this side, and then you've got the plug from the servos. Yeah, make sure you don't pull it, don't yank it, just take it nice and easy. Won't do any harm if you clean this area a bit. I'll leave this here nice and safe, and then won't make one harm if you clean that area. Just this is the panel that needs removing. So this, the wire of our stator, and now it's now all loose. You see, now it can be, we couldn't take it off because of here it was clamped hose tied to the wall, and now you've got one thing here, and then it goes there. You can see it moving already. So just remove that, and it's all loose now. And now we can start removing these bolts. Take this clamp off and make room here. Okay, remove it. Right, let's get on. I'll remove this one with this clamp that holds this wire and two bleeding pipes from that. That was easy. When you put these bolts back, make sure you put lock thread on it, on everyone, just a bit. Don't go too much, because this hardened. Oh, there's none on it. This is aluminium body, so just a tiny drop, you know, just. Right, so take this clamp off. Let's remove this. We can remove this easy. So we'll make more room here. We'll remove the sprocket cover. That will be easy. Alright, so I've took the sprocket cover off. I've zip tied everything here, so we've got room. Now we can carry on removing this cover. The stator cover, and expose the flywheel, the damaged one. Alright, now with the big bolts. And then expect to make a bit of mess. We'll see. All the oil should be down there in the pan, you know, but still. Just three of these big bolts, and 1, 2, 3, 4 smaller ones. I'll leave that one in place just for now. Release all the rest. I have removed the thing, and this is how it looks. All damaged. Stator all grind, and check inside the rotor, inside the flywheel, all magnets collapsed. I was lucky enough not to have anything. Hopefully didn't went in. Hopefully nothing dropped in there, you know. Oh. Now we need to unscrew these three bolts, take the stator out, remove this tiny one, take the wire, make sure you clean thoroughly. This is the gasket. Make sure you clean this as well, and you replace it. And just make sure you don't drop anything in there. replace it, we can put the new one back. Right, so this is the stator, yeah. That's the wire there, and it's being held in place by this plate and a tiny bolt which has lock thread on it. Make sure you put that back. And the stator is held by this three bolts also with lock thread. Make sure you clean that and replace that lock thread. And it goes like this. Look, just wiggle it and it will go out. And you can see it has two guiding things on it. And there's two holes, one here and one here, so you can't misplace it. Just goes in them two holes, just like that. When you replace the new one. And just make sure you've cleaned this thoroughly, and that, put the new gasket, and then you can put the new stator in. Now make sure you clean this again. That's the thing all cleaned. So I've shown you these two guiding pins, two notches, so it goes in these two holes. These other three are for the bolts. So for the like this, you can hear like a click thing. See, just a gentle notch, prime, and it's in. The wire seal goes like that. This is now moving. Now we've got then three bolts back, a bit of lock thread in each on each one of them, just like that, and then the plate back to secure the wire. And nothing gets in the way, so there you go. Brand new stator. Okay. Now we've got the flywheel. Need to make sure everything is clean. And we've got the gear assembly here. Well, the gear assembly, you've got this shocks, this bushing, rubber bushing. Well, these three spaces needs to go right in there. So try to line it up and then push it just. Make sure you look in this gap here and check that everything went in, and then you push it just like that. In the back, we've got this washer, and this spacer needs to go like that. There's a click motion, click thing. Well, you can feel it, right? And that's your gear assembly of the flywheel. Now we just need to make sure one more time everything is clean, everything is supposed how it's supposed to be, and then we need to push this through that bearing and then wiggle it a bit just to get the teeth aligned, you know, from the starter. It's nice and easy. I'm on the bearing now. that's it. Didn't went first from first thing, but now we are sure it's all in, all aligned, and it has to be like flush. The flywheel needs to be flush with this. Right now, new gasket, we'll put the gasket and then the cover with the stator. That should be close to being finished. New gasket, make sure when, just be gentle with it when I take it off. Don't want to damage it. It's only me. And it came with the kit. Yeah, just peel it nice and easy. Should be okay. Fit the joysticks time. Right. Now gasket. You can't place this wrong because you've got this bit there, that bit there, that guiding thing, and that should be right. We'll just make sure when we place this stator now. Take it off. Take it off for now. We don't need to. Don't want to damage that. Just feed the plug back. Make sure this is in place. Make sure you double check everything. Right. Now I can put this, I can put the seal back. And then so we've got the flywheel back, we've put these bolts, make sure you tighten all of them. If you can go like in a cross pattern like that, you know, just make sure everything is nice and flat. And we still need to get this one back. Throttle body needs putting back, and then the regulator and an airbox, and that should be it for this. But as we said earlier, we need to do the, we need to change the oil on it. So you've got the drainage plug here of the oil sump and the oil filter here, which is an easy access to it. Make sure you change those before you finish, before starting your bike, because stuff, you know, from this being all that grinding thing, all those magnetic strips, you know, debris can go in the engine. It can go in here, so you don't want that risk blowing your engine, right?
Bike is running and it's charging like it should be. 14 volts. So operation worked. That's a bit of smoke coming from that oil.